the world mourning the loss of the Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin, passing away this morning. She was at her home in Detroit. She had been battling pancreatic cancer. She was 76 years old. Franklin was an artist who not only sang about respect, she demanded it. Jeannie Moos is out front.
Aretha doesn't just get... She gets a lot. Imagine a president adjusting your footstool.
There you go.
Okay.
Sort of the same way she started around age 9.
They would have me stand on a little chair and sing.
Singing gospel, then singing soul. How did she make us feel? We have lost the greatest singer of our time, tweeted Billy Joel. Stars like Barbara Streisand and Oprah posted photos taken with her. The Queen of Soul died on the same date as the King of Rock, 41 years apart.
Are you lonesome?
Aretha wasn't lonesome. She died of pancreatic cancer at home with family. Temporarily, political bickering came to a halt.
You know, I'm sorry to interrupt. I'm very sad to report this morning.
Fans imagined Aretha walking through the gates of heaven like royalty.
Are you a diva?
No. Would I be a diva? I'm really very, very down to earth. I really am.
Dictionary.com honored Aretha with this entry. Even if the way she sang it made it harder to spell it.
R-S-P-E-C-T. Meant to her.
Respect won Aretha the first of her 18 Grammys. When they called to say she would be awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom, she thought,
is this a joke?
Her second husband, divorced but still close, said she had a wonderful sense of humor.
Can I ask you about sex? It's in a lot of your songs. I mean,
sex?
Well, lust.
Come on,
feeling.
No.
Good feeling.
You got me mixed up with somebody else, Ed.
Mix up Aretha? Not possible. She sang at Martin Luther King's funeral. She let freedom ring at the Obama inauguration. And at the Kennedy Center, her performance drove Carole King into ecstasy. President Obama didn't just sing along, he wiped away a tear. It happened again at another occasion when she sang America, and the Attorney General also cried, America! The Queen of Soul, able to touch our souls. Jeannie Moos, CNN, New York.
Out front now, Larry King, host of Larry King Now on Aura.tv and former host of Larry King Live, of course, right here on CNN. And Rock and Roll Hall of Fame member Sam Moore, known for the hit song Soul Man. He's known Aretha Franklin for more than 60 years. Sam, someone that you have known for so long, losing her. I know it has to be a tough moment. You're hearing so many remember her and sing in her honor, of course, about what an inspiration she was. What will you miss the most about her, your friend?
I think the difference would be the side that I recognize most about Aretha was the gospel side. The pop side was one thing, but the gospel side that I understood with her, the struggle, the hurt and everything that came out from her singing, the pop stuff, but the gospelist side that I really knew about Ree.
I mean, Larry, you know, you interviewed her, as you have so many people who are legends in this country and around the world. You talked to her just after she performed at President Obama's inauguration in 2009 in one of your interviews. I just wanted to play a clip from that.
What was that like for you yesterday?
What a tremendous mammoth morning, evening, the ball, just everything from one event to the other was just too much.
I mean, Aretha wasn't just an iconic singer. She was a civil rights activist. You know, you saw in Jeannie Moos there, Larry, President Obama crying And after he was crying when she sang, he actually put out a statement. He said, "American history wells up when Aretha sings." This is in part what he said to David Remnick of The New Yorker. "That's why when she sits down at a piano, she can move me to tears." And he basically said, "She captures the fullness of the American experience, the view from the bottom and the top, the good and the bad." And that was how he talked about her, what she did for America and for civil rights.
Yeah, and she was larger than her music. Can't say that about many performers. Her music speaks for itself. But she was larger than her music. She's a great American, very smart. She stood up for lots of things. But the way she sang and the way she moved people, you didn't need to use her last name. All you had to say was Aretha, and you knew who she was. She was quirky. I loved her little, you know, she wouldn't fly.
Right.
She wouldn't stay in a building over 8 floors. In other words, if when we booked her on CNN, our studio was on the 9th floor. And so she wouldn't stay on the 9th floor. So we had to interview her at the Mandarin Hotel on the 4th floor. Because she had those little quirks. But above all that, she was an amazing individual. And those are the kind of people that, when they come along, they're irreplaceable. You will never see another Aretha, ever.